Welcome students, for today's session we are in fourth unit series, A reading we saw, B reading we saw and C reading. The lesson name is The Emperor's New Clothes. So let us say this is also a funny story. You can have a fun at the end of the story. What kind of clothes the emperor had and how he made people to stitch for him. And all these things we are going to see. I will read it for you. This is an extensive reading. Listen carefully, observe in your book while reading, and learn how you have pronounced a particular word and where I am starting, how the grouping of the words. Everything you have to observe and learn on the reading skill. Many years ago, there was an emperor who was so fond of new clothes that he spent all his money on them. You see, many people like wearing new clothes every time. Everybody, now these days especially, you know, those people, those who are doing YouTubes, those who are doing TikToks, you know, there are many people those who are giving the videos on YouTubes and all, they like to change their dresses very. Every video they have a different dress. You know, they like to wear the new kinds of dresses, new variety of dresses. And here also we have a king here, he also likes to wear new kinds of dresses. Every time he wants to wear a new dress, a new variety of dress, a new design. So this is a kind of king we have, emperor. So he spent all his money, always he spends a lot of money for only clothes. One day two men came to the emperor's court. We are weavers, they said. We can make the most beautiful cloth in the world. The emperor was very happy. So one day, two men came to the king's, the emperor's court and said, we are the weavers. We are the weavers. And what they said, we can make the most beautiful cloths in the world. And already our king, our emperor is the mad of cloths, is very lavish on the cloths. And now these two men came and said that they are able to make wonderful cloths in the world. And the emperor was very happy. Our cloth is also very special, said the man. They also said one more thing. My dear king, my dear emperor, our cloth is very, very special. It has some speciality. It has some peculiarity. What is it? Only wise men can see it, fools cannot see. So what is the special of that particular cloth what they make is only wise men can see, only clever people can see, the fools cannot see the cloths. They cannot see the cloth, fools cannot see the cloth. That is the speciality of the cloth what we make. That's very good, thought the emperor. When I wear cloths made with it, I will know who is wise and who is foolish. Now the emperor is very, very happy. Why? Because it has its own advantage for the emperor. What is that advantage? Now, yes, I need that particular kind of dress. I want that particular kind of a dress. Why? If I wear, I can know in my kingdom who is the clever, who is the foolish. Who is wise and who is foolish. Now he is able to identify these kind of two people in his kingdom. That is the advantage he wants to have by wearing that particular dress. The emperor gave the men a lot of money. Start weaving at once, he told them. What he said? He gave them a lot of money. Okay, use this money. Take this money and start. Today itself you start the work. Start weaving, he said. They set up two rooms and pretended to be very busy, though they had nothing at all on the rooms. So what they are doing, they started two rooms there in the palace itself, and they pretended to be very, very busy, very, very active there, and actually they were not doing anything. They are pretending, they are acting as if they were busy, but in reality they are not doing anything at all, simply passing the time. They asked for the finest silk and the purest gold thread. They put these in their own bags and they worked at the empty looms until late night. So what happened? They asked the finest, purest gold silk they asked, gold thread they asked, and the finest silk they asked, and the king gave them. Whatever the king has given, that went to their bags, their pocket. So they did not spend anything on the cloth. And they pretended as if they are working till late night. I should like to know how those weavers are getting on with my cloth, thought the emperor. Only wise men can see the cloth. I will send my old minister, who is the wisest man in the court. So now the emperor thought, okay, only the wise people can see my cloth, but I want to see how these people are working there. So only wise people can see. Let me send my minister, the oldest minister there, so that he can come and give a message, the news about my cloth. So he thought he wanted to send the old minister. So the good old minister went into the room in which the men were working at the empty looms. What can be the meaning of this? Thought the old man, opening his eyes wide, very wide. I cannot see anything on the looms. When the old minister went to the room where these people, the weavers, working, and he entered there, he could see nothing. There was nothing there. And how these people are working here, I can't see anything here. So this is what the minister thought. He was not able to see anything there. Then immediately he wanted to ask these people. Come a little nearer, said the man to the minister. Isn't the cloth beautiful? So immediately when they saw the minister, they asked him, my dear minister, please come little more near. Just observe here. Is the cloth beautiful? The cloth that we are working, is that beautiful? They pointed to the empty rooms. The poor old minister looked hard. He could see nothing on the rooms, for nothing was there. So immediately, when the people asked the minister to come near, he went near. My dear minister, can you see how is that? Was the cloth beautiful? Is the cloth beautiful? Now, when he looked, he opened his eyes wide and saw there was nothing. Nothing was there. And now he is getting surprised. How come these people are working without anything? This is the surprising, surprise thing that he had. What? He thought, is it possible that I am a fool? Well, sir, said one of them, how do you like the cloth? I was thinking, I wish that I am a fool. I can't see anything there. And then immediately, one of the weavers said, sir, how is the cloth? Do you like the cloth? Oh, it's splendid, the minister said. Evanadu, what did he say? It's splendid, it's beautiful, it's wonderful. Why? Because I immediately thought in his mind, only wise people can see the cloth. Now, if the minister says I can't see anything, then those two weavers will complain to the king that this minister cannot see anything, then he is a fool. And there is a danger, king can remove this particular minister from his office. So, this is what he sensed and immediately said, well, it's very beautiful. Now the emperor thought he would like to see the cloth. So he called his officers and went with them to the weaver's room. Isn't the cloth beautiful? Said the old minister, pointing to the empty looms. How is this? Said the emperor to himself. I can see nothing at all. Am I a fool? Oh, it's beautiful, said the emperor aloud. So what happened? Emperor wanted to see the cloth and took all his officers to the room where the weavers were working. And when they went there, quickly, Emperor looked at that and saw there was nothing good. Similarly, he said to himself, "What is this? Am I a fool? I cannot see anything here." But immediately thought, "Okay, if I say there is nothing, then these people will think about me that I am a fool." Then immediately king said, "Wow, what a beautiful cloth! Yes, it's very beautiful." Immediately the king said,